exposures to the Variety Club, and a wonderful name comes to mind by the name of Buddy Rogers.
Yeah.
And Buddy Rogers, what a sweetheart he was. Mm-hmm. I mean, he was, I think it was the winner of the first Oscar ever for Wings or something like that, but a good looking. And he was very involved in the Variety Club. And I think he made the first presentation of a van from Variety Club to Angelview.
Very likely.
Nice.
Yes. Yeah. But you guys got a great history. You do great work.
You know, Angelview has, I don't even know how many vans. They have a whole stable.
Oh, yeah. We probably have 12 vans today, something like that. We've got a bunch of trucks for the thrift marts.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, Angelview does great work. And Bob Brown, who's a friend of yours, you got to know him because Bob is a musician, and he used to go up, and maybe still does, I don't know, entertain the kids at Angelview.
Bob Brown has been coming to the Angelview Christmas party, which we have at the Guide Dogs facility on the way up to Desert Hot Springs, and we bring all the clients there. It's something to see, and Bob Brown has entertained there every year as long as I can remember. He comes up, on occasion, comes up with his daughter.
Wow.
And they sing and they play for the kids, and Hopper the Clown comes up, and it's really happening.
That
see all these
special.
Kids together. Yeah, yeah. It really is.
Well, that's part of the individual effort of a Variety volunteer, you know, reaching out to the children. Why should we're struggling a little bit today? We're behind last year. We felt pretty good about we raised 71 plus thousand last year, but we're probably 5,000-6,000 off the mark today. And I've been trying to figure out how to reach out to people. Why should people, even if they have to sacrifice something, why should they go to that trouble to donate to Variety, the children's charity?
Because there's always somebody who's more in need than they are. And it is so rewarding to help out somebody in need, especially in times like this where you're hurting. The only way you could feel good, you can't go out and buy yourself a new car or a new house, but you can help somebody else who needs it more than you do. If you see some of the recipients of what Variety Club does, if that doesn't get you to do it, that's the end of the story. But the Variety Club does a lot of wonderful
things. I hope you had the opportunity to see video of the little boy back in September at Lincoln Elementary. We did our first adaptive bike, you know, the very expensive bikes that are custom made for these children who can't ride your typical bikes. But just one look at his face. If that wouldn't make you donate, I don't think you would ever donate.
There are so many inspirational stories. You know, one I'd just like to tell because it's an Angelview story. There's a child up in Angelview who is totally paralyzed, and the young lady can move nothing but her eyes. But they developed a computer, and her eyes only go up and down and sideways.
Yeah.
And with this computer in her eyes, she writes emails.
Oh.
I mean, it's unbelievable to see she's back in the world. She can communicate just by her eyes. That's the only thing that moves. It's her eyes up and down and sideways. And you sit there and you watch her in a wheelchair staring into this contraption that's hooked up to a computer, and she writes emails.
Wow.
But what they do today for the disabled and for the people with problems is unbelievable. But it takes money to do that. And it's donations, and it's Variety Club, and it's Angelview that you have to give to get things like that to happen.
Mel, there was a young fella at Angelview that I got to know. Greg was his name. And we were doing I think it was either the first or the second radiothon. We did it down at the mall, down in Palm Desert.
Mm-hmm.
This fella took the bus. He's a wheelchair. He took the bus and however many connections he had to make and so on and so forth on a hot day to get down to the mall because he wanted to make a donation. So he comes up there. I recognize him. Greg, how you doing? He comes over, and he wants to write a check. I said, well, we'll do that for you. No. It took this kid 5 minutes to write that check. Everybody wants to help him, you know, but he was bound and determined. He was going to write this check for $10, and he was going to do it. That's why he went to all that trouble to come down there. He was going to write out this check, and he was going to present it. I'm telling you, we were talking about it on the air, and such a flood of donations.
Yeah.
You just gave me goosebumps. I just came from Greg's 35th birthday party.
Is that right?
He's been at Angelview since he's 18 months old. I walk in, Mr. Haber. That's Greg. He's got a personality, remembers everybody's name. 35 years old.
Wow. Woo!
I asked Greg this question one time. I said, Greg, if there were, by some miracle you could suddenly walk, he said, what do you think you'd do? He said, I think I'd go to the Empire State Building. I said, would you take the elevator or take the stairs? He laughed and laughed and laughed.
Oh, he's been our poster boy. If you see our trucks around town, he's one of the kids in that picture.
Yeah.
He's got a personality that doesn't quit. And it just shows you that they can have full lives and be bubbly and be optimistic. He's wonderful.
35 years old, my God.
35, since he's 18 months old.
Yeah, well.
That's great.
He made his donation that day, boy. And I'll tell you, there wasn't a dry eye in the house. And people donated from all over the valley because they're great. Mel, thanks for coming down.
My pleasure. Good luck.
Thank you, Mel.
Lots of luck. Nice to see you.
Sorry to hear about the fact that you're no longer with us.
Yeah.
But
you will say nice things about me now that I'm gone.
Yeah. Was it your death is seriously exaggerated?
Yeah, exactly.
Or
Mark Twain.
Mark Twain.
The stories of my death are grossly exaggerated.
Yeah,
thank you guys. Lots of luck.
Thanks, Mel. We really appreciate it. Mel Haber, ladies and gentlemen, big friend of Angel View, and he likes variety. He loves variety.
Oh, yeah.
And we love Mel.